We are looking at chapter number 3, the Delhi Sultans. We are taking question and answer on the Delhi Sultans. Which ruler first established his or her capital at Delhi? So the Tomar Rajputs were the first rulers who established their capital at Delhi. What was the language of administration under the Delhi Sultans? So it was Persian, Farsi. In whose reign did the Sultanate reach its farthest extent? It is under the reign or under the emperorship of Muhammad Tughlaq. From which country did Ibn Battuta travel to India? From Morocco, which is in Africa. So Ibn Battuta belonged to Morocco, Africa, and traveled to India. According to Circle of Justice, why was it important for military commanders to keep the interest of the peasantry in mind? So peasantry is or was the backbone of the entire kingdom. The king could not do anything without it because it was the source of revenue. The soldiers get their salary or got their salary which came from this revenue only. So it was necessary to keep the peasants, or you can say the farmer community, prosperous and happy, because only then they could be able to pay revenue. Now it becomes clear why the military commanders kept the interest of the peasantry at top. Why? What is meant by internal and external frontiers of the Sultanate? So the internal frontier means the hinterland of the garrison town, while the external frontier means the areas beyond the hinterland of the garrison town. What were the steps taken to ensure that the Muktis performed their duties? Why do you think they may have wanted to defy the orders of sultans? So the steps which is asked here is accountants were appointed by the state to check the amount of revenue which was being collected. And care was taken that the Mukti collected only the taxes prescribed by the state and not more than that. And it was also taken care that he kept only the required number of soldiers. The Muktis may have wanted to defy the orders of the sultans because their appointment was not hereditary. Also, their job was transferable. So what is more, the condition of services were severely imposed, or service was severely imposed on them, which they did not like. What was the impact of Mongol invasions on the Delhi Sultanate? The Delhi Sultanate, the answer is like this. The Delhi Sultanate mobilized a large army, a standing army in Delhi. So it posed a big administrative challenge. So Alauddin Khilji constructed a new garrison town at Siri for his soldier. He imposed taxes on land to feed the army at the rate of 50% of peasant yield. He began to pay the soldiers in cash. And Muhammad Tughlaq shifted people of Delhi to Daulatabad in south, and therefore converted Delhi into a garrison town. He also disbanded the army, and he also paid the soldiers in cash. Do you think the authors of Tawarikh would provide information about the lives of ordinary men and women? Not really. This is why, because the author of Tawarikh lived in cities, mainly in Delhi. So they have to go, they had need to belong to these people, or the place where these people live. So they were not in touch of village people. They often wrote their histories for Sultan in the hope of getting good or rich rewards. So they had nothing to do with common mass. Therefore, it was obvious that the information provided by them would lack ordinary men and women. Razia Sultan was unique in the history of Delhi Sultanate. Do you think women leaders are accepted more readily today? Yes, of course, women leaders are accepted more readily today. If you talk about 2019, then you see the defense minister, the foreign minister, the speaker of the Lok Sabha, and you know, mostly you will find women in very good positions. So the situation has to change today. Due to the spread of education, people now realize the potential of women. So they have started accepting them as their leaders. even in rural areas, now we see women sarpanches and councillors. Why were the Delhi Sultans interested in cutting down forest? Does deforestation occur for the same reasons today? The answer is the Delhi Sultans cleared the forest in Ganga Yamuna Doab and gave these lands to peasants in order to encourage the agriculture. They also established new fortress and towns in these lands to protect trade routes and to promote the regional trade. The answer for the second part is no. Deforestation does not occur for the same reasons today. Nowadays and today's scenario, vegetation cover is being reduced due to overpopulation, population increase, urbanization, urban settlements, and commercialization and industrialization. Find out whether there are many buildings built by or any building built by the Delhi Sultans in your area. So I just leave it to you, because if you are in Delhi, then you'll be able to answer. Otherwise, you need to take help of the other people like parents. Who defeated the Tomar Rajputs and when? The Chauhans of Ajmer defeated the Tomar Rajput in the middle of 12th century. When did the Delhi Sultanate lag its foundation? So the actually it's laid. You can say laid. So the Delhi Sultanate laid its foundation in the beginning of 13th century. Name the five dynasties that together made the Delhi Sultanate. So it's early Turkish rulers: Khalji dynasty, or Khilji dynasty, Tughlaq dynasty, Sayyid dynasty, and Lodi dynasty. Mention the sources that provide a lot of information about Delhi Sultans. So inscriptions, coin, architecture, and history written by Persian by learned authors are some of the most important sources that provide a lot of information about the Delhi Sultans. Why did the author of Tawarikh write their histories for Sultans? So they did so in the hope of getting rich rewards like money, like land, etc. Razia. Why was Razia removed from the throne? Actually, she was a women ruler and she was not favored by most of the people, especially on the elite level. So she ruled just for 4 years and was finally dethroned in 1240. What is a mosque called in Arabic? It's called as Masjid. What is the literal meaning of mosque? So it refers to the place where Muslim prostrates in reverence to Allah. What is Qibla? The direction towards which Muslim turn while offering prayer or namaz, that is the direction of the Makkah Medina. This is the direction where the Muslim turn and pray, offer their prayings. Why did the early Delhi Sultans favor their slaves? Actually, the slaves were totally dependent on their master. Therefore, the Sultan could trust and rely upon them. And mostly the slaves, sometimes they are very good as far as their workaholicness and their IQ are concerned. So the Delhi Sultans, when they saw that there are some people who are very good, that's why the early Delhi Sultans, they favored these slaves, that those were very good. What was the duty of Muktis? So the duty of Muktis was to lead military campaigns and maintain law and order in their iqtas, that is, those areas. Why were accountants appointed by the state? So they were appointed to check the amount of revenue which are collected by Mukti. So it's a regulatory body, you can say. Why did the authors of Persian Tawari criticize the Delhi Sultans? So they do not like the Sultanate policy of appointing the low and base bar to high offices, that is those people who are of influential family or influential caste, you can say. So they are not from a very rich family, but still they were given high offices, high posts. Name the three type of taxes collected during the Sultanate period. So tax, first of all, on cultivation called the kharchi, and amount to around 50% of whatever peasant, the yield means whatever they produce, 50% is given, has to be given to the Sultanate. And the cattle and houses also, they carry tax on them. For how many years the Suri dynasty ruled? So the Suri dynasty ruled for 15 years, only for 15 years. Who were the authors of Tawarikh? Write in brief about them. So the author of Tawarikh were actually learned men. They were secretaries, administrators, poets and courtiers who recounted events that were happening at that time, as well as advised rulers on governance, emphasizing the importance of the justified rule. So the authors of Tawarikh lived in cities, mainly in Delhi, and therefore they were cut off from the village. They used to write histories in praise of sultans, and in return they would get rich rewards. So these authors advised rulers that they should follow an ideal social order based on birthright and gender distinctions. So common mass has nothing to do with their ideas. Who was Razia? Razia Sultan. Why was she not accepted as a sultan in spite of being talented? You know. So Razia was Sultan Iltutmish's daughter. She became Sultan in 1236 and she was very talented. According to the chronicler of that age, Miraj-e-Siraj, she was more able and qualified than all her brothers and sisters. But she was not accepted when she became a ruler. Those were the days where women were not allowed to enjoy independently these high posts. They were not able to enjoy, or they can't even reach there. So they were supposed to be subordinate to men, and this led to her removal from the throne in 1240. Just 4 years she ruled. What were the four stages in the making of manuscript? So there are four stages in making a manuscript. First, we need to prepare the paper, or you can say at that time preparing the paper, then writing the text on it. If some important words or messages are there, then melting gold to highlight them, and then finally the binding. How did the Khalijis and Tughlaqs help the people to of humble birth? How did it lead to political instability? So the Khalijis and Tughlaq, they raised people of human, humble means very low profile birth, who were often their clients, to high political position or elite position. So they were appointed as generals and governors. However, this also introduced an element of political instability. The slaves and clients, the people of humble birth, were loyal to their masters and their patrons, but not to their heirs. Means not to those, you can say, those people who governed them. They were no doubt loyal to the masters, means to the Khalijis and Tughlaqs. So now Sultan had their own servants. As a result of the accession of new monarch, this often saw conflict between the old and the new nobility. Why did large parts of subcontinent remain outside the control of the Delhi Sultans? What were the repercussions? So large part of subcontinent remained outside the control of Delhi Sultans. Why? Because they were very far from Delhi. For example, if it was difficult to control Bengal from Delhi or South India from Delhi. So the helplessness of the Delhi Sultans paved the way for distant provinces who are quite far to get independence. So even in the Gangetic Plain, there were forest areas that Sultanate force could not penetrate. So it was the golden opportunity for the local chieftains and local leaders to establish their rule in these regions. How did the chieftains arrange for their defense? So the chieftains fortified themselves in mountains, in rocky, uneven, rugged places, as well as in the bamboo groves. So the bamboo had unique features. It was strong, and even fire could not affect it because the branches are so intertwined. This makes the bamboo groves very strong. So the chieftains lived in these forests, which served them as rampart. So they had everything necessary for life, like the cattle, crop, water, etc. inside the forest only. So they were safe. Only powerful armies could subdue them. Why did Alauddin control the prices of goods in Delhi, and what did he do for this? So Alauddin Khilji gave importance to his soldiers, because it was they who could defend the Sultanate from the outsiders or the invaders. So he decided to pay their salaries in cash rather than iktas. So the soldiers would buy their supplies from merchants in Delhi, and it was thus feared that merchants would raise their prices. So to stop this, Alauddin controlled the prices of goods in Delhi, and for this Alauddin instructed officers to carefully survey the prices and to control the prices. The merchant who did not sell their good at the prescribed rate were punished. Described in brief, Tughlaq's policy of token currency. So Tughlaq did not control prices of goods. Instead, what he did was he used a token currency made out of cheap metals and not of gold or silver. So people in the 14th century did not believe in these coins. They saved their golds and silver coins and paid all their taxes to the state with this token currency. So this cheap currency could be easily counterfeited. Who was Sher Shah Sur or Sher Shah Suri? What do you know about his administration? Sher Shah Sur, from 1550 to 1545, established a powerful state. He started his career as the manager of a very small territory of his uncle in Bihar, and eventually challenged and defeated the Mughal Emperor Humayun. Sher Shah captured Delhi and established his own dynasty known as Suri dynasty. Although the Suri dynasty ruled only for a short period, that is only for 15 years, it introduced an administration that borrowed elements from Alauddin Khilji and made them more efficient. The great Emperor Akbar followed the techniques of Sher Shah administration while consolidating the Mughal Empire. Give an account of Alauddin's administrative measures. So during the reign of Alauddin Khilji, Mongol attacks increased, or they started invading. So it was a huge administrative challenge for the Sultan now. So he introduced several administrative measures. First, Alauddin raised a large standing army as a defensive measure, last standing army. He constructed a new garrison town known as Siri for his soldiers. The soldiers had to be fed. This was done through the produce collected as tax from the lands between Ganga and Yamuna, and tax was fixed at 50% of the peasants or farmers' produce. He paid his soldiers cash salary rather than ikta, and this was done in order to make soldiers able to buy their supplies directly from the merchants in Delhi. So it was feared that merchants would raise their prices. So in order to curb that, to stop this, Alauddin control the prices of goods in Delhi. So prices were carefully surveyed by the appointed officer, and merchants who did not sell at the prescribed rate were actually punished. So Alauddin's administrative measures were successful because he efficiently withstood the threat of Mongol attacks. Give an account of Muhammad Tughlaq's administration. So the early years of Muhammad Tughlaq's reign faced Mongol attacks, which were curbed by or stopped by Tughlaq's sincere effort. He took several administrative measures like Alauddin Khilji. He also raised a huge standing army. He got emptied the oldest of the four cities of Delhi, that is Delhi Kulha is actually Kuhana, Delhi Kuhana, in order to garrison his soldier there. Now the residents of the old city were sent to new capital, which was Daulatabad in the south. He made arrangements for the collection of produce as tax to feed the soldiers. As it was very difficult to maintain a large number of soldiers, the Sultan levied additional taxes which coincided with the famine in the area. So Muhammad Tughlaq paid soldiers cash salaries. For this, he introduced token currency made up of cheap metals. People in the 14th century did not trust these coins, so they saved their gold and silver coins and paid all other taxes to the state with this token currency. Muhammad Tughlaq's administrative measures were a failure. Explain with example. So we can prove this, how his administrative measures were failure. He campaigned into Kashmir, which was finally a disaster. He then gave up his plans to invade Transoxiana, that is today's Uzbekistan, and disbanded his Raj army. His administrative measure created problems. He shifted the residence to the old city to the new capital of Daulatabad in the south. And people did not like this step taken by Muhammad Tughlaq. They resented collectively altogether. Tughlaq, in order to meet expense of maintaining a large number of soldiers, he actually levied additional taxes, which increased the burden of common people. And at the same time, the famine in the Ganga Yamuna belt led to widespread rebellion among the people. So Muhammad Tughlaq policy of token currency also proved a failure. So people of the 14th century did not trust this currency. They were very smart. They saved their gold and silver coins and paid all their taxes to the state in the token currency only. So this cheap currency could easily be counterfeited. That's why his administrative measures were actually failure. So these were the question and answer of this topic. Thank you so much and take care of yourself.